Professor T. Paapireddy Garu onto the dais. Please be seated. I welcome both Vice Chairmen, Telangana State Higher Education Council, Professor Limbadri Garu, Professor Venkatramana Garu, then Professor Gopal Reddy Garu, Registrar Usman University, other professors, student winners, and representatives of New Age Consultancy Services, who have voluntarily come forward to sponsor the prize money to the winners, to the Connect Chancellor Prize Distribution Ceremony. My dear students and all dignitaries, good afternoon. Now I request all the dignitaries to rise for the national anthem. I request Honorable Governor Madam to light the lamp. I also request Professor Paapireddy Garu and Dr. Soundarajan sir to also associate Governor Madam. The moment lockdown was imposed, Honorable Governor Ma'am was thinking about all the students of the state. Because of closure of the schools and colleges, students tend to lose positive and competitive spirit. In order to engage and encourage students, Honorable Governor Ma'am conceptualized this innovative program, Connect Chancellor, to provide ample opportunities to the students of all the state universities to project their innovative, novel ideas and fertile imagination in the form of articles, stories and poems in English, Hindi, Telugu and Urdu languages, with the present COVID-19 pandemic as central theme. All state universities responded positively to this initiative and disseminated the message to reach out to all the students to enable them to participate. I am happy to announce that the response from the students was fabulous and overwhelming. About 6,500 students, English around 4,567, Telugu 1,474, Hindi 259, Urdu 127. Students participated in this program. Winning is not everything. Participation is more important than just winning. I appreciate each of the students for their participation in this program. Each of the students who have participated shall also be given a participation certificate. They can download the certificate of participation from the link that we are going to send today through their email. The Telangana State Council of Higher Education and Usmania University took great pain to evaluate the entries through experienced panel of professors. Resultantly, you are all here. I thank Chairman Professor Paapireddy Garu, Vice Chairman Professor Limbadri Garu and Professor Venkatramana Garu of Telangana State Higher Education Council for handholding entire program and making it a grand success. I also thank Professor Gopal Reddy Garu, Registrar of Usman University, and his team of professors for evaluating the entries and gave the result on time. I also thank Sri Etikala Ravindra Reddy Garu, Chief Executive Officer of New Edge Consultancy Services, who voluntarily agreed to sponsor the prize money. I also thank Professor Sadanandan Garu, IT Cell Head of Telangana State Higher Education Council, for developing the software that is required to send e-certificates of participation and the software required to send email to all the participants. This program distinctly reflects the care and concern that Honorable Governor Ma'am has towards higher education and academic excellence of the students. Madam has also taken lead role in guiding the state universities for conduct of online classes to the students so as to complete the syllabus and save the academic year. Governor Madam has also been reviewing the performance of each and every state university, duly interacting with the functionaries of universities through video conferences. The vision of Honorable Government is to make Telangana as the leader in the field of higher education. I congratulate each one of you, the winners. We could not allow the parents and friends of the students to this Darbar Hall for maintaining social distancing during this COVID pandemic. I'm sure you can understand. Now I request the chairman of the Telangana State Higher Education Council, Professor Papi Reddy Garu, to address the gathering.
Good afternoon to all of you. Her Excellency, the Governor Madam of Telangana State, Madam Tamilsai Soundararajan Garu, Sir, and the Principal Secretary to the Governor's Office, Surendra Kumar Garu, and my colleagues, Professor Limbadri Garu, Professor Venkatramana Garu, and the Professor Gopal Reddy Garu, Registrar of Usman University, the Venkat Sri Ram Garu, Controller of Usman University, my another colleague, Professor Srinivas Rao Garu, Secretary, Telangana State Council, and one more member, O.N. Reddy Garu, and the distinguished participants from the Telangana State. Really, it is a great happy moments for everybody, because today is the sixth year after formation of Telangana State, and incidentally today also the Governor Madam's birthday also. We have to greet everybody to the Madam. In the context of the COVID-19, the Governor Madam has taken a lot of initiations. First, she convened the meeting with all the universities, and she has given some direction to all the universities how to engage your students in a productive way. Don't waste the students' time. This is a precious time. Even in the adverse circumstances also, how best we use this time for the betterment of the students. On that words, the State Council has initiated so many review meetings with the universities. Even we had a meeting with the NAC and the AICT also. Once the Governor Office approached to the State Council, the Madam is thinking in this way, connect Chancellor. Then we welcome that move. Definitely, State Council will take this issue as a very serious challenge one, and we have to do whatever we want. Then we will give the much publicity to the all the universities. This is the current chancellor regarding of the COVID-19 contest. Always the students use their time in various creative activities through poems, essays or other things. We thought the maybe 1,000 or 2,000 students may participate, but to my surprise or our surprise, the 7,000 over 7,000 students have participated in this event. Really, madam, I thank the initiation. This much of the students, they have participated. Then the Surendra Mohan Garu and other of his team, please, you have to do one more thing to evaluate all these 7,000 participants and give the award list, the ranking. We have scrutinized everything with the help of the Usmania University teachers, particularly Gopal Reddy Garu, Sri Ram Garu, and Govardhan Garu. They have done a lot of work day and night and completed within the time, and we have given to the our results to the Raj Bhavan with their satisfaction. For this, I thank both the State Council officials as well as the Usmania University team. Nearly 20 teachers have involved in the evaluation. I do thank their participation. As far as the participants are concerned, the four languages, English, Telugu, Hindi and Urdu. English has a more number, Telugu follows Hindi, then Urdu. But the madam has given equal rating, though English is more. Therefore, already Surendra Mohan has mentioned, the participation itself is a great thing. I congratulate all the 7,000 students who participated in this event. And in future also, madam has already initiated the further course of action for all the students in the universities. How to engage your time. Now we have the medium, how to address the students is the only online classes. Therefore, how best we use that platform to impart the education effectively to the university students. That is the major concern of the governor, madam. Thank you for, madam, your concerns toward the Telangana state and the Telangana university students. I congratulate all the winners of this participation. With these few words, I thank the governor, madam, and his team. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Paapireddy Garu. Now I request Honorable Governor Ma'am, we are celebrating two birthdays, one birthday of Telangana and birthday of Honorable Governor herself. Now I invite Honorable Governor Ma'am to kindly address the gathering.
Very special good afternoon to each and everyone. And first of all, I wish you all a very happy and prosperous Telangana Formation Day, for which each and every citizen of Telangana was dreaming of. And really, I am very fortunate to be having my birthday also on the same day. It's a divine coincidence, I think. When I was celebrating in a much simpler way as a school student or as a medical college student or as a social person, as a political leader, I didn't think my birthday will coincide with the birthday of a state and that state to which I will head the state. So it's almost a divine coincidence. So I really thank you all. Thank the Almighty God for giving me this opportunity. And my respects to Professor Poppy Reddy, Chairman, and Professor R. Limbodin, Vice Chairman, Professor V. Venkatramana, Vice Chairman, Professor Gopal Reddy Garu, Registrar, Osmania University, Professor Sriram Venkatesh, Controller of Exams, Dr. J. Upendra, Nodal Officer, and Sri Dayakar Rao, who all helped in evaluating the exemplary entries. First of all, I want to congratulate almost all the 7,000 participants who participated in this Connect the Chancellor competition. I congratulate each and every one because participation itself is a success. And my respects to Dr. Professor Soundararajan, who always at the back of me, besides me, and in front of me, helping me to come forward in my life. And my best wishes to Secretary Garu, because Secretary Surendra Mogan took maximum efforts to make this program a grand success. And I also thank our Joint Secretary, Additional Secretary, and our Liaison Officer, my ADCs, and all the security officers. Apart from that, all Rajbhavan staff, including our photographer. And apart from that, my respects to all the press friends, media friends, who are present here. We have to see the opportunity in everything, whatever may be the situation we face. And as Chancellor of Universities, I thought that students have very good potential, because when I have visited the universities, colleges, the way they questioned and the way they presented, really they are too intelligent. I used to say, because you know I am a medical professional, I used to say when I go to the colleges, I used to say, I won't be jittery when I present my presentation in a conference of scientists. I won't be jittery when I talk in a big conference of political leaders. I won't be jittery when I talk in a galaxy of meeting of doctors, but I always be jittery when I talk in a college, particularly school and college, because the present generation is much intelligent than our generation. That I have to accept. They are so intelligent, even when such things, because when we read the presentations, it was really a very difficult job. Who to be selected, whom not to be selected, because all the entries were exemplified entries. So I really congratulate. I want to congratulate all the participants who have been selected for the prize. But I want to congratulate all the participants. So we wanted to provide them a certificate. So at that time, when we press a button here, almost all the students who participated will get the certificate through their email. So nobody should be disappointed. If I am giving, they have graded the entries. If I would have given the opportunity, definitely I will select all the 7,000 students, because I cannot deny the effort of any student. So, but in life we have to run and catch the opportunity. Whatever may be the situation, we have to find the opportunity in that. So when I was talking to my secretary, Mr. Surendra Mohan, and my officials, then I thought students are sitting at home. Definitely their potential is too much, so they let them not waste their time. So let us, it's a simple beginning. It's not a great thing, I have to say. It's a very simple beginning, but definitely this simple beginning will reap great results in the state of Telangana, particularly in the higher education. The higher education department, the higher education section of Telangana should occupy the topmost position in our Bharat. That is my aim, whatever may be the challenges, because we have to visualize challenges in each and every situation. This is COVID. Everyone thinks this is a situation, a challenging situation we have to face. It's a medical calamity which we are facing. But whatever may be the position or situation, we have to face it. I used to tell a small story. I don't know, in my Twitter I post 1 minute motivation stories. I don't know how many of you have seen that. In that I have mentioned in one of the stories, actually one CEO will select two officers, sales officers. He sent both of them to a island to identify the opportunity of that sale of their product, that is the shoes and chappals. One went and came and told, there is no any opportunity at all. We cannot market our products in that island at all. The CEO asked, why you are telling that? Why you have come to a conclusion like that? The sales officer to be selected, who came for the interview, he told, I am a marketing person, I can assess the situation, we are producing chappals and shoes, but when I went to the land, nobody is wearing chappal or shoe. They don't have the habit of wearing at all, so we don't have a market there. He went away. Other person came, who went to the same island, he came and told, there's ample opportunity to sell our products. Then the CEO got confused. Same island only we sent both of them. One came and told there is no any opportunity at all because they are not having the habit of wearing chappals or shoes. This person is telling we have ample opportunity. Then the CEO asked, why you are telling that? The salesperson, that is the marketing person who came for the interview, he told, I went there, I observed, nobody is wearing chappals or shoes. So when we create a habit of wearing chappals or shoes, we have ample opportunity to market our products in that island because nobody is wearing. So we have ample opportunity to market. So the same situation, one optimistic person, how he is viewing, one pessimistic person, how he is viewing. So we have to identify the opportunities. Whatever the situation we see, whatever may be, it may be a negative situation. It may be a negative situation. When we put just a line in front of it, it may become a positive situation. So in this situation also, COVID, we are viewing like that only. COVID has actually created a lot of things in our life or as well as in the social pattern. Now we have to view back our tradition. What our grandmother was telling, what our mother was telling, what she was telling. My grandmother won't allow anybody without washing their hands and their legs. But what we are now doing, previously we used to tell what this old lady is telling. No, we won't obey. What is this? She is practicing untouchability. I will go. What is this? What is this habit? Now what we are doing? We not even water. We have to sanitize ourselves and then we are entering. Then food habits. Now we are telling, eat garlic, eat turmeric, eat ginger. That's where the tradition food which we had, but we all actually omitted everything and then we ran behind some of the footsteps. I used to always tell to the students, be modernized, but don't westernize yourself. Be modernized. So like that we have to, now COVID has taught a great lesson to each and every one. So whatever may be, we have to live with it. So we have to, how long we can be in the lockdown. I'm really very happy the country didn't move into the fifth lockdown. Now we are in the unlocking situation. But unlocking situation means that it doesn't mean that virus is on the way to its home. It's not that. Virus is with us only. It will live with us only. It will catch our heads and neck, and it will bother us only. But we have to live with it. So whatever may be the situation, whatever may be the challenges, we have to face. Coming to the higher education gives opportunity to each and every youngster to come up in his life. So previously there were only certain departments so that the students get trained in that and they have to look for their job opportunities. But now so many new branches have emerged. We can select before and all when we were youngsters, they used to tell what you are going to take as your profession. Most of them will say, I'm going to be a doctor, I'm going to be an engineer. Then some will say, I'm going to be a teacher. Some will say, I'm going to be a lawyer. But now, so many branches, whether it is artificial intelligence, whether it is biotechnology, so many things, and allied health sciences, so many branches have emerged so that we can identify what are the branches which are near to our heart, which we can practice to our maximum extent so that we can put our maximum efforts in that so that we can come up in the life. So I really very happy. But as my secretary, Mr. Surendra Mohan, said here, we are analyzing all the universities. First, we had two rounds. Our registrar and all, they participated. They were really, I appreciate all the staff of the Higher Education Department of Telangana. Immediately when we interacted with them, they initiated the online classes, and the online classes are going on. Certainly there are some drawbacks. I cannot say it to its full extent, to success it is running, but anyhow at least 50 to 60% of students are benefited by that. And apart from that, when the students are not reachable, they may be living in a remote situation where no any internet facilities are there, then we are thinking of creating digital libraries for them. So no student in the state of Telangana should be deprived from getting the higher education. That is my aim. Whether they may be living in a tribal area, they may be living in a village area, but they should be provided the highest opportunity to get them trained in the qualification so that they come up in the life with flying colors. And apart from that, students, I appeal, because I used to be, when I was a student, I used to take all the opportunities, whether winning or not, we have to participate. So only I was thrilled when I learned the number of the participants. Really, when this short duration, in this critical situation itself, my students from Telangana is taking the opportunity in such a way, in other situation, definitely the students of Telangana will take all the opportunities and they will lead our country in the field of education. That I am very well aware and I am very well confident on that. So I am really very happy about the students. So much of opportunity should be given to them. They are with so much of potential. So whatever may be the opportunities given to them, this is, as I said, is just an initial stage. So I want all the students who are studying in the government universities, they grab the opportunity and they should be given the opportunities. So here we are there to take care of you. So be courageous, be bold, take your studies very seriously, and be very careful in selection of your course, and be a very exemplified person so that you can come up in life in a very great manner. And apart from that, I want to congratulate all the students, because they are girl students are there, boy students are there. It's an opportunity to each and everyone, but they have obstacles. I used to narrate one Tamil poem always, because there are obstacles in each and every field. It's not just a smooth path for everyone. The path may be filled with thorns, the path may be filled with stones. We have to go through that path to reach our goal. So we should not get disappointed when we face some of the obstacles. So I used to say, there is a Tamil poem saying that a tree will grow. It will spread its branches. This gardener will cut it, because no gardener will like the tree which he is growing to spread its branches and going away from the out of the fence. So he used to cut. The tree will get worried and get disappointed. What is this gardener? I want to grow. I am growing and spreading my branches. This gardener is cutting it. So what is that? One tree got disappointed and it drooped away. But the other tree told the gardener indirectly, it narrated, this gardener is cutting my branches. Let him cut. Whatever may be the branches growing out the fence, let him cut. But he cannot cut the roots of me. So I will spread my roots. I will be strong in this field. Even though if he cut my branches, he cannot cut my roots. So I will be in this land field with my strong roots, so that the gardener will get tired cutting my branches, but I will be eternal in this world, spreading my wings later and giving flowers and giving fruits to this country. So like that, we have to be very courageous. We have to see challenges in whatever may be the critical situation. And as a chancellor, not only as a chancellor, as the first person, citizen of this Telangana, and a person who is much interested in the education, because but for education like us, because I learnt my medical education, first I started in the Madras Medical College, then I entered Thanjavur Medical College, where my husband started the dialysis and the transplant unit. Then I got married when I was doing my first year, because I am the eldest daughter of four daughters and one son. So I am the eldest daughter. So I got married when I was doing my first year itself. Truly it's an arranged marriage only, it is not otherwise. So, but I took my exams more confidently and I passed in all the, no arrears at all. So I'm not telling I'm a more intelligent student. I'm a very hard working person. So when I was appointed as the governor, some of my media friends like that in Tamil Nadu asked, have been appointed, you are the youngest governor, you have been appointed as the governor of, because for youngsters I am telling this, or governor of Telangana, are you an extraordinary person to get that post in this age? I told, I am not an extraordinary person, I am a very, very ordinary person, but doing things in an extraordinary way, whatever may be the opportunity given to me. So I want to say this to our youngsters. So whatever may be the smallest opportunity we have to use it to its full extent so that we can come up in life. So because now there are ample opportunities for you. You can select your field. You can now, your parents are very cooperative with you than the earlier generation. Now the generation, mother, father are bringing up the children in a much understandable way. They are moving with the children in a much friendlier way. They are moving as friends. Some children can accept that, some children cannot accept, because some of the parents may be more strict parents, but whatever may be, they are doing things for our good. So another thing, I am really fortunate, because I didn't think that when I came here as a governor, I can do such great things, but this is a new state. There are ample opportunities not only for the students, for the governor also. So, so many things we can concentrate and we can bring up, we can be a part of a person who contributes to the development of this state. So, I really wish you all the best, and this is not an end, this is the beginning. So, each and every student of Telangana can feel there is a friend of them in Raj Bhavan. That's all I can say. A single word I can say. So, a friend is, it's not a governor in Raj Bhavan. A friend of the students is in Raj Bhavan, who has a high ambition of developing the higher education in Telangana. I don't want to leave anything, even the smallest opportunity. I want to my full extent, I want to develop the universities so that with each and every university we are interacting. Tomorrow we are going to interact with Osmania University. 2 days back we interacted with the Kakatiya University. So till June 30th, I am interacting with all the universities so that we can know all the what are the drawbacks, strengths and weaknesses of the universities, so that it can be developed. And because our education department and the system can be useful to the students with its full of its extent, and the students get the maximum opportunity in the state of Telangana. And I really very confident within few years Telangana can lead India in the education and in the higher education. I am very confident. So Jai Telangana, Jai Hind. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Honorable Governor Ma'am, for giving enlightening, enchanting, educating and encouraging message. I request students present here to disseminate the message of Honorable Governor Ma'am to their friends and fellow students. Now, I request Honorable Governor Madam to click the button to send the email to all the students who have participated in this Connect Chancellor program. Yogendra. Now I request representatives of New Energy Consultancy Services Mr. Dayakar Rao, Mr. Visu, Mrs. Pragati, and other representatives to hand over a cheque for 3.43 lakh rupees to Honorable Governor Ma'am. This amount will be used to give cash prizes to all the winners today. Now, Honorable Governor would like to interact with few of the students who won the prizes today. So, I will call some names randomly. Raunak Bain. Raunak Bey, P. Sweta, Nitya Shri, Maunika, Tejaswini, Rajeshwari. Any of them? If you are ready, tell me. Pass on chain. Mike. Please raise your hand, please.
Jai Hind to one and all, and good afternoon. First of all, I would like to greet a warm greetings to our Honorable Governor Ma'am. Many more happy returns of the day, Ma'am. And happy Telangana Day, Telangana Formation Day to everyone. I am Lady Cadet Shweta from Telangana Social Welfare Residential Armed Forces Preparatory Degree College for Women. I am very happy to receive the award from the ma'am. I am very thankful to our Honorable CM KCR sir, because he brought the idea of a woman join in armed forces and to take the preparation of army. And also I thank our Praveen Kumar sir to executing the vision of CM sir. And also I thank Colonel CN Reddy sir and Major Usha Sharma ma'am for executing the Praveen sir's and CM KCR sir's vision. Ma'am, you said that every student in Telangana will fly like a color. So I was the one of the color of that flying, ma'am, because I am very poor girl, but I have got an opportunity in Armed Forces Preparatory Degree College, and also I have good opportunity to take award from your hands, ma'am. And I would like to give a message to our country. I think there is no college like our college in the country, because we are getting so much of మాకు చాలా అవకాశాలు వస్తున్నాయి ఆపర్చునిటీస్ సారీ మాకు చాలా ఆపర్చునిటీస్ వస్తున్నాయి అక్కడ మాకు ఎలా ఉంటుందంటే ఒక ఆర్మీ పర్సన్ మాకు అది ఎలా యూజ్ అవుతుందంటే మా ఆఫీసర్ పర్సనాలిటీని డెవలప్ చేసుకోవడానికి చాలా యూజ్ అవుతుంది అక్కడ ప్లస్ అక్కడ మాకు ఏం నేర్పిస్తారంటే ఫెయిల్యూర్ని లవ్ చేయడం ఒక ఫెయిల్ మేము ఏదైనా దాంట్లో ఫెయిల్ అయితే దాన్ని ఎలా లవ్ చేయాలి దాన్ని లవ్ చేసి మళ్ళీ దాన్ని ఎలాగ మనం సక్సెస్గా మార్చుకోవాలనేది మాకు అక్కడ నేర్పిస్తారు అదేవిధంగా మాకు ఈ ఆపర్చునిటీ ఇచ్చినందుకు మ్యామ్కి థ్యాంక్స్ చెప్తుంది థ్యాంక్ యూ మ్యామ్ జై హింద్ టు ఎవ్రీవన్
A very good afternoon to everyone. Good afternoon, ma'am, and a very happy birthday to you. I wish we could have sang a song for you, but I don't think it's possible. First of all, thank you very much for giving this opportunity, because once you finish your schooling or once you come out of your 11th and 12th, we often don't get opportunities to show out our talents, because everyone gets very engrossed in their professional lives, their career making and all. So this was a very refreshing opportunity for us. And relating to the situation, the COVID situation, I would like to just talk about just of what I've written. So firstly, yes, this COVID situation has brought a change of how people think about doctors. I myself am a medical student. I'm first year medical student at Bhaskar Medical College, Moinabad. Previously, you know, doctors were thought like, you know, they are just money making people. Like mostly people have that mindset, and even getting into a medical college, or it's a stigma that, you know, getting in is all about spending money, and it's a whole lot of years, you'll not earn, start earning quickly, and it's all about earning every time when you choose a career. But this one such career, I'm not saying that any other career is less or something like that, but this is a very noble career, and hands down to every doctor, every compounder or every nurse, everyone serving right now, because now without them, I think our country, or in fact the whole world, would have been in a chaos. So thank you, as even you are a doctor and I think many are there over here. So a very big thank you to everyone who has chosen this profession, and also to every person who is out there who is still working, like our guards, our hygiene maintenance people, and many others who are still working, who were still working in spite of the lockdown. Though there was this COVID fear hovering upon all of us, and they still kept serving. A big thank you to them as well. I learned one thing, that nothing is big or small. Everything is important for the world to run in a systematic manner. Every profession, be it an engineer, be it the politicians, be it doctors, be it our housemaids, everyone is very important for this world to run in a systematic way. And this COVID situation has taught us that, and I hope everyone starts respecting people whom we haven't respected till now, and also start taking this opportunity and of learning our own responsibilities towards our house, towards our state, our country, because I believe in this one thing, that if one person changes, looking at that one person, a family can change, that a society can change, and thereby, you know, the world can change. It's a very difficult thing, but yes, it is very much possible. And yes, ma'am, as you told, it's not about being an extraordinary person, it's about doing extraordinary work. And you need not be a high IQ level person to pursue anything big in life. It's all about hard work and your attitude towards life. So that's what I wanted to say. And thank you so much once again, ma'am. And thanks for everyone. Thank you to everyone.
Now I request Honorable Governor to distribute the awards to the merit certificates and cash awards to the winners. All winners will receive merit certificate and cash awards. For first prize, the cash award is 15,000 rupees, and for second prize it is 10,000 rupees, and for third prize it is 5,000 rupees, and one consolation prize in each category it is for 2,000 rupees. In fact, we are very conservative, a bit conservative in proposing the cash awards, but madam has increased it threefold. That is the liberal mindset of the madam towards the students and higher education well-being. Now I read out the names. First, English language. In articles category, Mr. Raunak Baid, BBA second year, St. Joseph Degree College, Usmania University, first prize, Certificate of Merit and Cash Award of 15,000. Miss M. Nikita, BSc second year, New Science Degree College, Kakatiya University, second prize. Ms. K. Madhuri and Mr. T. Varun. This article was jointly written by them. Madhuri is BCom second year student, Government Degree College, Begumpet. Mr. T. Varun, Bachelor of Hotel Management from Dr. Narayana College of Hotel Management, Usmania University. Both are from Usmania University. Consolation prize in articles category goes to Gajjala Srichandana. She is Pharma D student from Vageswari College of Pharmacy, JNTU, Hyderabad.
part of Honorable students, ma'am. They work for society and they change the society because they. నేను చాలా బాధపడ్డాను మేడం. కరోనా ఎఫెక్ట్లో మేము చేయలేకపోతున్నాం. ఈవెన్ ఆశా వర్కర్స్ పిహెచ్ఎంస్ వాళ్ళు కూడా ఏదో ఒకటి చేయగలుగుతున్నారు. మేము ఇన్ని ఇయర్స్ సిక్స్ ఇయర్స్ కోర్సు చదివి కూడా ఇంట్లో కూర్చుండి ఈ లైఫ్ మాకేంటి అని అనిపించింది మేడం. ఆ టైంలో ఈ ఛాన్స్ వచ్చింది. ఈ ఇది రాయడం వలన మీకు కనీసం నేను ఏం చేయలేకపోయినా మా మమ్మీ ఒక్కటే చేస్తుంది. మీ చేతిలో రాకపోయినా ఇంకా హయ్యర్ లెవెల్స్ ఉన్నారు వాళ్ళ చేతిలోనే ఆయన జరుగుతుంది. కాబట్టి ఇప్పటివరకు నేను అనుకున్న అయితే చెప్పాలనుకుంటున్నా మేడం. మేము కూడా చదువుతున్నాము లైఫ్ మీరు అన్నారు కాబట్టి చెప్తున్నా.
Now English stories category. Now English stories category. Miss P. Sweta, MZC, Telangana Social Welfare Residential Armed Forces Preparatory Degree College for Women, Bhuvanagiri, Mahatma Gandhi University, Nalgonda. Please give all winners a big round of applause so that they will be encouraged. Second prize goes to Bandi Devanand, BTech ECE second year, VBIT Hyderabad, JNTU Hyderabad. Third prize goes to Miss Shruti Medharametla, MBBS first year, Mahatma Medical College Khammam, Mamata Medical College Khammam, Kalaji Narayan Rao, University of Health Sciences. Consolation prize goes to Dr. Uma Ramana Prakhya, MDS second year student from MNR Dental College, Sangareddy, Kalaji Narayan Rao, University of Health Sciences. English poems. First prize, Miss C.R. Nichesri, MBBS first year from Bhaskara Medical College, Kalaji Narayan Rao, University of Health Sciences. Dr. Isha Tiwari Arora, DM in Nephrology, sir, DM in Nephrology. She is final year student in NIMS. Third prize goes to L. Sankirtana, MCOM final year student, University College of Commerce and Business Management, Usmania University. Nagasrikar is there? Okay. Nagasrikar. No. Then Telugu language. In articles category, Miss Pebeti Ramya Reddy, MBBS third year student from Kamineni Institute of Medical Sciences, Narkatpalli, under Kalaji Narayan Rao University of Health Sciences. Miss D. Monica, MBA second year, Satavahana University PG College and Satavahana University. Third prize, Gudikandula Teja, BCom Computers first year, Bhavans Vivekananda Degree College, Usmania University. Consolation prize goes to Dr. Srinivas Reddy Atla, B.Ed. Special Education for Mentally Retarded, first year from Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University. In poems category, first prize, Edavalli Saidulu, research student in Telugu, Usmania University. Edavalli Saidulu. Stories. ఎడవలి సైదులు రాజేశ్వరి రాజేశ్వరి సెకండ్ ప్రైజ్ మిస్ రాపర్తి రాజేశ్వరి బిఎస్సి సెకండ్ ఇయర్ గవర్నమెంట్ డిగ్రీ కాలేజ్ భద్రాచలం కాకతీయ యూనివర్సిటీ తర్వాత రవీంద్రాచార్య మనమద రామకృష్ణ ఇస్ దేర్ రామకృష్ణ సో కన్సల్ కన్సలేషన్ ప్రైజ్ గోస్ టు మిస్టర్ బి రవీంద్రాచారి డైట్ కాలేజ్ హనుమకొండ ఇన్ తెలుగు స్టోరీస్ ఫస్ట్ ప్రైజ్ మిస్ పి తేజస్విని ఎంఎస్సి సెకండ్ ఇయర్ ఫ్రమ్ ఉస్మానియా యూనివర్సిటీ కాలేజ్ ఫర్ ఉమెన్ ఉస్మానియా యూనివర్సిటీ సెకండ్ ప్రైజ్ గోస్ టు జీడి రమేష్ రీసెర్చ్ స్కాలర్ యూనివర్సిటీ క్యాంపస్ కాకతీయ యూనివర్సిటీ థర్డ్ ప్రైజ్ గోస్ టు మిస్ ముల్కుల నేహ బీడీఎస్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ మేఘనా డెంటల్ కాలేజ్ అండర్ కాకతీయ కళాజీ నారాయణరావు యూనివర్సిటీ ఆఫ్ హెల్త్ సైన్సెస్ కన్సలేషన్ ప్రైజ్ గోస్ టు వి మహేష్ ఎంటెక్ స్ట్రక్చరల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ సెకండ్ ఇయర్ స్టూడెంట్ సిఎంఆర్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ అండర్ జేఎన్టీయూ హైదరాబాద్ నౌ హిందీ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఫస్ట్ ప్రైజ్ ఇన్ పోయమ్ కేటగిరీ నవ్యశ్రీ సంగం బిఎఫ్ఎస్టీ ఫోర్త్ ఇయర్ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఫుడ్ సైన్సెస్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ అండర్ అగ్రికల్చర్ పండి ప్రొఫెసర్ జయశంకర్ తెలంగాణ స్టేట్ యూనివర్సిటీ ఫర్ అగ్రికల్చర్ యూనివర్సిటీ సెకండ్ ప్రైజ్ మిస్టర్ హరీష్ శర్మ బీటెక్ ఫోర్త్ ఇయర్ మర్రి లక్ష్మారెడ్డి ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ అండ్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ అండర్ జేఎన్టీయూ హైదరాబాద్ థర్డ్ ప్రైజ్ మిస్టర్ బికాస్ సింగ్ పియూసీ టు ఆర్జేయుకేటీ బాసర్ కన్సలేషన్ ప్రైజ్ డాక్టర్ అంజలి మాసి మాస్టర్స్ ఇన్ పబ్లిక్ హెల్త్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఇండియన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ పబ్లిక్ హెల్త్ హైదరాబాద్ అండర్ కాళోజీ నారాయణరావు యూనివర్సిటీ ఆఫ్ హెల్త్ సైన్సెస్ దెన్ ఆర్టికల్స్ ఫస్ట్ ప్రైజ్ హనీషా వంగారి బీటెక్ ఫోర్త్ ఇయర్ స్టూడెంట్ క్రీస్తు జ్యోతి ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ అండ్ సైన్సెస్ జేఎన్టీయూ హైదరాబాద్ సెకండ్ ప్రైజ్ వి సాయి హర్షిత బిఏ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ సెంట్ యాన్స్ కాలేజ్ ఫర్ ఉమెన్ ఉస్మానియా యూనివర్సిటీ థర్డ్ ప్రైజ్ వల్లూరి శరత్ చంద్ర బీకామ్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఐఎస్ఓ డిగ్రీ కాలేజ్ ఉస్మానియా యూనివర్సిటీ కన్సలేషన్ ప్రైజ్ అగ్రిమ ఠాకూర్ మాస్టర్స్ ఇన్ డెంటల్ సర్జరీ సెకండ్ ఇయర్ ఆర్మీ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ డెంటల్ సైన్సెస్ under College Narayan Rao University of Health Sciences. Now Urdu language. First prize in articles. Ayesha Mubin Taj, BA third year, NTR Degree College for Women, Mahbub Nagar, Palamur University. Third prize, Mohammed Mustafa Arafat, Research Scholar, Telangana University, Nizamabad. In stories category, Noor Mohammadi, Research Scholar in Urdu, Usmania University. Noor Mohammadi. First prize. Urdu stories second prize, Mohammad Manjeer Hussain, MBBS first year, Government Medical College, Nalgonda, under College Narayan Rao, University of Health Sciences. Third prize, Humaira Fatima, B.Ed. first year, Mughal College of Education, Usman University. In poems category, first prize, Abdul Sabur, MBBS first year, Dakkan Medical College, Hyderabad, under College Narayan Rao University of Health Sciences. Second prize, Maliha Tauriyat, B.Tech first year, Kartiya Institute of Technology and Sciences for Women, JNTU Hyderabad. This prize distribution is over. Now Honorable Governor will felicitate the professors who have helped in this Connect Chancellor program. First, Professor T. Papi Reddy, Chairman, Telangana State Council of Higher Education. Professor Papi Reddy garu. Professor Papi Reddy garu. Professor R. Limbadri, Vice Chairman, Telangana State Council of Higher Education. Professor V. Venkatramna, Vice Chairman, Telangana State Council of Higher Education. Professor C.H. Gopal Reddy, Registrar, Usmania University. Professor Sriram Venkatesh, Controller of Examinations, Usmania University. Dr. J. Upender, Nodal Officer, Statistical Cell, Usmania University. Sri Dayakar Rao Vesapogu, Director, New Age Overseas Consultancy Services, who sponsored today cash award to all the winners. The representatives of New Age Overseas Consultancy Services will be well stated by Honorable Governor. Please raise for national anthem. Kindly raise for national anthem.
जनगणमनाधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा कलवंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलधितरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभाशिष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जनगण मंगलदायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता नहे जय हे जय 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 हे.
थैंक यू. Snacks and tea are arranged. Snacks and tea are arranged in the other hall.